Alright, Rod. Alright. Here's the scene. You just have to come through this tunnel and act really scared, because the Rochester Reaper is going to be right in front of you, okay? It's going to be awesome.
It isn't actually going to show up, though, right?
Come on, Rod. It'll be like filming a scene from Harvey. Nothing will happen. We're going to CGI it in post or something.
But what if it is real?
Relax, dude. The Reaper is a myth. A cloaked man who goes after people. It's just all old rumor glorified by writers. Oh, yes, and he used to dwell within this tunnel right here. Ooh, scary. Come on, get it together, Shaggy. It was probably some dude in a Halloween costume. Look, this scene is going to make you a star. So, just, let's get to it, okay?
All right, let's get this over with.
All right. And cut. Rod, that was perfect. Rod, the scene is over. What's wrong?
You don't see him? You don't see it? The guy in the suit?
Ah! What was that all about? I guess Rod really stepped into the...
Harmless holiday, Halloween, full of ghouls, ghosts, and goblins. Every in the Twilight Zone is a locked wing for someone to have the scare of their life. These tales are infused with the literal spirit of Halloween. We invite you if you dare, because on tonight you will see the most petrifying stories on the Twilight Zone. William Kelly, every year dressed up as a character from his favorite franchise in the world, Star Trek, for this year's costume. He is becoming the brave, handsome Captain James T. Kirk. However, something is unique about this costume. The communicator is an actual prop from the show. A prized possession to William, and also cost him a fortune. This here is Richard Lloyd, a young man who not only despises William, but the precious franchise of Star Trek, and would rather enjoy a show with more starfighters and lightsabers.
No, I have everything. Trust me, I do. All right, I'll see you there. Okay, bye bye.
This story can show how jealousy can lead someone to the wrong sector of space. Richard's about to take a warp speed trip on Twilight Zone.
Oh my gosh, what kind of nerd gets this type of stuff? In fact, what kind of nerd gets this and then forgets it? Oh gosh. I wonder what would happen if it would go missing for a little bit.
Thank you. Enterprise is making this summer beyond awesome. Enter for a chance to win great prizes at enterprisebeamsyouup.com and see Star Trek Beyond in theaters July 22nd.
Live long and prosper.
Until we can beam you up, we'll pick you up.
All right, class. Today we will be discussing how Romulus and Remus were in a constant battle with each other. Many officers died during the battles, and many ships were lost. But luckily, the Federation was able to make amends.
Hello?
Hey, Rich. How's it going?
Oh, hey. I've had a bad day. It's like, I think I'm losing my mind. Ever since I stole it from a prop from this nerd Kelly. Yeah, nerd Kelly. I've been seeing like Star Trek things and hearing them everywhere.
That weirdo Kelly must be going out of his mind.
He's not the only one. Yeah. Okay. Maybe I should just go to the cafeteria, get some food. I'll call my parents, maybe. Hey, talk to you soon. Bye.
Oh, yeah.
Kelly! Okay. Oh, my gosh. Chris. I realize. In the past, I haven't exactly been the most friendly to sort to you, but I found this. Yes, and I think it belongs to you.
Oh! I've been wondering where this was. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Just take it. Just take the damn thing. I don't ever want to see it again.
No, but really, I want to repay you for this, and, you know, I've been using my friend's phone, but it's about time I got this back, because I need to contact my friends.
Okay, Kelly, this is not time for play acting now. I am serious, and I don't want to see it again.
No, really, I want to repay you. In fact, why don't you come with me? I'm actually going trick-or-treating on Ferenginar. It never stops raining. It's perfect atmosphere.
Enough, Kelly! You got a contact? You got to contact a spaceship?
Well, it's not spaceship, it's actually a starship. Here, let me show you. Ensign Kelly to Enterprise.
Spock here.
Two to beam up.
Standing by.
Okay.
Jealousy is a vice that can lead to negative impacts on people. Mr. Lloyd has just found out what happens when you obtain something precious to someone and try to apologize. Along with Mr. Kelly and Mr. Lloyd, who is now living and serving in shock and fear, all because he performed an act which got him into the Halloween section of The Twilight Zone.
Tara Hotel, I'm sorry, we don't have any vacancies. When will we? Let me check. It seems you're in luck. Something just opened up.
The Twilight Zone Tower of Terror. Drop in if you dare.
Thank you.
last segment may feel familiar to some. This one will ask if someone sees something scary, the other will receive it. This will send them on a one-way trip to the Twilight Zone.
Remember when we used to go trick-or-treating?
We've been used to.
Well, we don't anymore. We're getting too old.
I still hang out at home and scare
kids.
Yeah,
no kidding. Get your stuff out of that locker. We're going to be late.
Trick-or-treating. I remember trick-or-treating. You still go out in a ridiculous costume vending candy at people's houses, don't you?
That costume, yeah, the one looks like your face. Scared the heck out of everybody.
Good one.
Did you realize that Halloween music just did not fit?
Yeah, I know, that's crazy. It didn't really fit in the party at all.
Makes sense, though. There is no music for Halloween.
What do you mean there's no music for Halloween? Of course there's music for Halloween.
There is no music for Halloween. I'll challenge you to some Halloween music, and we'll play Name That Tune.
All right, fine. I'll start.
The Addams Family. You know the song.
I do.
Keep going. The Thriller by Michael Jackson.
What about this one?
Monster Mash.
Yep.
It was a graveyard smash.
Yep.
That's a good one.
Ghostbusters!
Who are you gonna call?
Ghostbusters.
There you go.
Ghostbusters was good, but I can think of one more song.
That was Twilight Zone. That was a great show.
Yeah. One of my favorites.
Yeah.
Can't go wrong with the 80s stuff. It's so twisty and scary.
Yeah, it is. You can't beat the classics. Rod Sterling was the classic.
It's true.
William Shatner in the plane episode to the assassination of JFK.
That was the 80s.
No, you're wrong. It was the 50s.
That was the 80s.
I'm telling you, I was around then.
What about the version with Forrest Whitaker?
Oh yeah, in the early 2000s, it was good.
Did you ever see the movie?
Twilight Zone, the movie? You bet. That incident when they were filming, that was wild.
Remember the prologue with Aykroyd and Brooks?
Yes, classic Zone moment.
Is this something scary?
Come on, Albert. You really want to quote that now?
I'm serious then. Do you want to see something scary?
Better yet, let me go down the hallway. You can put on your prosthetic mask and then scare the heck out of me on the way back.
Okay, you got it. Whatever.
Okay, I'm going.
Sounds good.